Welcome, Age of Vintage Society. Before Princess Diana entered into her grotesque misalliance with Prince Charles, she was just a 19-year-old who liked to party. She may not have been following strict protocol from the palace, but it's obvious she loved a royally good night out. Thanks to a friend lending the royal his clothes, Diana was able to go incognito and have a carefree night out on the town. Why was Princess Diana dressed as a man by Freddie Mercury? Make sure to watch the video until the end and leave your thoughts in the comments. If you are new here, join our wonderful community by subscribing to the Age of Vintage channel. The very mischievous Princess Diana. When Freddie Mercury put Princess Diana in drag and smuggled her into a club. Princess Diana was beloved by people all over the world, and many were devastated when her 1997 death in a Paris car crash was announced. The princess, who was hailed for her charitable work in Africa and for helping fight the stigma against those battling HIV/AIDS, was full of love for those she helped and her family, as well as a rare few celebrity friends. As written in history books, for centuries the most powerful members of the royal family tend to come off as stuffy and conservative. That began to change in 1981 when 19-year-old Lady Diana Spencer married Prince Charles and brought youthful energy and a new spirit to the staid monarchy. Diana was quickly embraced by the British people and she embraced them back, becoming a popular icon who hung out with artists and celebrities and ventured out into public whenever she could, even if she sometimes had to wear a disguise to do so. Diana was close to a number of trailblazing rock stars in the 80s, including Elton John and Freddie Mercury, the legendary lead singer of the band Queen. While her relationship with John was very well documented, the friendship with Mercury largely flew under the radar until actress Cleo Rockus told an incredible story about the pair in her 2013 memoir. It's a story that's now become embedded in urban legend. But were they really close friends? There are certainly different accounts of this, with some suggesting the pair never even met in their lifetimes. With that being said, other accounts suggest they were good friends. A magical, crazy night between our Queen of Hearts and the Queen of Queen at a bar in South London. But did two of the most famous people on the planet really get away with something so audacious and shocking, especially in public, in front of hundreds of people, and nobody noticed? A photo hit the internet showing the pair cozied up together, but what does it prove? We all know that Princess Diana quite enjoyed dabbling in a bit of rule-breaking from time to time, whether in private or on a big public stage. So it really isn't too surprising to learn that she also enjoyed partnering up with another acclaimed rule breaker. Freddie Mercury and Princess Diana were, clearly, cut from a very different cloth. The Queen frontman occupied the stage with vigour, dancing and prancing and singing his heart out to fans. In contrast, Diana, Princess of Wales, was a far more reluctant public figure. An unlikely friendship, perhaps, but the two were technically a different kind of royalty. However, it seems as though they hit it off in more ways than one. In fact, the pair regularly spent time with each other. While Freddie Mercury and Princess Diana's friendship wasn't caught on camera, a wonderful story of Diana sneaking out on the town with the Queen frontman has come to light. According to Rockus, she became close with Diana in the 1980s, and one evening the women were hanging out with Mercury and the comedian Kenny Everett at Everett's London home. The group was enjoying an early evening of watching the Golden Girls on mute and making up racy dialogue for the show's leading ladies when Diana asked the rest of the group what they were planning on doing later that night. The princess was clearly down to have a good time and they all loved hanging out with her, but the three friends figured that their plan to go dancing at Royal Vauxhall Tavern, the iconic London club, wouldn't be all that interesting to Her Royal Highness, but Diana surprised them all by requesting to tag along to the club, consequences be damned. At the time, Princess Diana had been catapulted to the height of fame and was the subject of intense media scrutiny, while her friends had reservations about what would happen if the outing was leaked to the press, Diana was reportedly keen to join them. The worry was that Diana would be snapped by paparazzi as she headed out for drinks with the group, but Freddie was not as hesitant and insisted she join them. Diana said that she was in full mischief mode, and Mercury agreed, "Go on, let the girl have some fun." But there was just the question of how Diana, one of the most well-known faces on the planet, could pass off unnoticed to other clubbers. The answer? By making her a rather eccentrically dressed male drag model. They disguised the princess as a man in a baseball cap, sunglasses, and an army bomber jacket. She did look like a beautiful young man. It's quite the endorsement of their work that it allowed Diana, easily one of the most famous women in the world, with a face that everyone in Britain could have recognised, blend in alongside Mercury. She and Freddie spent the evening giggling like naughty schoolchildren. Upon arrival at the club, Diana went undetected. The friends inched through the leather throngs and thongs at the bar, where the princess was even able to order drinks, a glass of white wine and some beer, without blowing her cover. When we walked in, we felt she was obviously Princess Diana and would be discovered at any minute, but people just seemed to blank her. She sort of disappeared, but she loved it. The gang then left after just 20 minutes, presumably for an after-party that was too spicy for even Rocco's to put down in print. Once the transaction was completed, we looked at one another, united in our triumphant quest. We did it. The friends may have only stayed at the bar for 20 minutes before moving on, but for one night at least, Mercury helped the princess break free. Diana became one of the most recognisable faces in the world after she wed into the royal family by marrying Prince Charles in 1981. For Princess Diana, living life within the British royal family was no easy task. Unfortunately, she had no idea what she was getting into. As the wife of one of the most visible men on the planet, Princess Diana became a massive celebrity in her own right. Later in life, the princess would speak openly about how difficult this was for her. She became a staple for the paparazzi, which made her liaisons with Freddie all the more remarkable in the fact that she managed to escape the attentions of waiting cameramen. Her relationship with the royals soured after she divorced Charles, and despite staying at Kensington Palace, she allegedly became convinced that there were spy cameras throughout the residence. Princess Diana wanted people to know her side of the story. In interviews following her separation and subsequent divorce from Prince Charles, Princess Diana got candid about the hardships of royal life. She also spoke about building a life for herself that wasn't in the middle of a media storm. Living life under a microscope is extremely challenging. For the British royal family, who choose not to respond or react to rumours, it's even more troubling when someone feels like they can't comment or defend themselves. During her marriage, the princess used the press to put a spotlight on her charity work and to bring attention to things like the AIDS crisis. However, following her divorce from Prince Charles, Princess Diana wanted the world to know what royal life was like from her perspective. Unfortunately, all of that media attention only fueled the public and press's obsession with the Princess of Wales. Princess Diana's aides pulled up floorboards and unscrewed the ends of the telephones over her concerns that she was being spied on, her former butler has claimed. Diana believed that she was being followed and watched. She was under surveillance, whether it was phone hacking, spying. There were occasions where we pulled up the floorboards and unscrewed the end of the telephones to see if there were any listening devices. The princess wasn't paranoid, but she was concerned. The statement by the National Security Agency comes amid media reports in London about secret recordings of Diana's telephone communications that apparently surfaced during the British investigation into her 1997 death in a Paris car crash. It's reported that US authorities had bugged Diana's phone without the approval of their British counterparts on the night of her death. It said US officials assured British officials the secretly recorded conversations shed no new light on her death. Mercury wasn't the only A-lister to bring out the royals' cheeky side, as Princess Diana even enlisted her friends to help play a 13th birthday prank on Prince William. Supermodels Naomi Campbell, Christy Turlington and Claudia Schiffer, who William mistakenly recalled as Cindy Crawford, in a 2017 documentary, Diana, Our Mother, Her Life and Legacy, Prince William opened up about the embarrassing experience. He said, Princess Diana, she organised when I came home from school to have Cindy Crawford, Christy Turlington and Naomi Campbell waiting at the top of the stairs. I was probably a 12 or 13 year old boy who had posters of them on my wall, and I went bright red and didn't quite know what to say and sort of fumbled, and I think I pretty much fell down the stairs on the way up. The supermodels have recounted the experience as well, with Turlington confirming that Schiffer instead of Crawford was there and said, Diana adored those boys. Princess Diana's royal chef, Darren McGrady, also recalled that Princess Diana had gone out of her way to embarrass him, as she also ordered a cake designed to look like the biggest pair of boobs. Prince William fondly recalled that his mother was the joker of the family and that the supermodel encounter was a very funny memory that's lived with me forever. Princess Diana was arguably the most famous woman in the world. It only makes sense that she would be pals with Freddie Mercury. Princess Diana and Freddie Mercury remained friends until he died in 1991 from AIDS. Everett would also die from the disease. Princess Diana didn't last long after and would die in 1997 in a tragic car accident. The legacy she left behind is carried on by her children and all the media attention she received. We are grateful for the intimate glimpse into the friendship between two of the most significant figures of the 20th century. If you liked this video, don't forget to give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you are new here, and if you want to support my work, please visit my Patreon page. Now it is your turn. What do you think about the friendship of Diana and Freddie? Keep in mind this purportedly took place at the height of Diana's popularity and demonstrates her willingness to buck the traditional norms and restrictive protocol of the British royal family.